All right, what's going on, YouTube? We have a rough, big day ahead of us. Tomorrow, we're starting our long journey to Africa. I mean, we're riding in the car to DC, then we have to hop on a 15-hour plane ride. So needless to say, I won't be able to train at all tomorrow. So to make up for that, today I'm training twice. So I'm going in at 11 o'clock for my push hypertrophy day, and then I'm going in at 7 o'clock this evening for heavy squats and then hypertrophy for, you know, glutes, hamstrings, all that. I'll take you guys along for the ride, but, you know, I could use this time like any other YouTuber to, you know, do some sort of pseudo motivational rant about how, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do to follow your dreams and you can't let anything get in your way. But in all honesty, this is what I'm passionate about. So doing this extra work, you know, is not something that I'm having to, you know, force myself to do. It's something that I enjoy doing. And honestly, if I could get away with training twice a day, every day, I would probably do it just because I enjoy it so much. But obviously, as a natural athlete, you know, the recovery demands of working out 6 hours a day would just leave you way overtrained. And just, it wouldn't be a good idea. But going back to the whole pseudo-motivational thing, I mean, I may not be the strongest guy on YouTube. I'm definitely not the biggest. I'm not the leanest. But there's one thing when it comes to this stuff. No one else will work harder than me. And that's not because, you know, I have some crazy work ethic or I'm so, you know, determined to reach my goals. I just love it. I love working hard at this, at my passion. So that's what I'm going to do. But anyways, since we're training twice today, the demands as far as recovery, as far as nutrition, are going to be a little bit different from a normal day. So typically, my macros are 220 protein. I know that's kind of high. 70 fat, and then fill the rest of my calories. I think it's about 350 grams of carbohydrates. Now, since we're training twice today, we obviously need to eat more to help us, you know, fuel up, replenish glycogen and all that. So to do this, I'm basically going to eat as little fat as possible and then just kind of, I don't know the exact amounts I'm going to overeat. I would say probably about 300 to 400 calories over, so that's probably an extra 100 grams of carbs. Although since I'm not eating as much fat, the carbs will go up again, so that's probably going to be maybe 200 extra grams of carbs. So this morning, I'll put it on the screen now. Typically, I have, you know, 6 eggs. Instead, I had some 2 servings of oatmeal and some protein powder, just mixed that together. Then about an hour later, I had my pre-workout carbs, and so that was some caramel rice cakes and then a Clif bar, just trying to find stuff. We obviously haven't gone grocery shopping since we're leaving for, you know, 9 days. So I had to find what I could that was high in carbs, low in fat. And then now we need to talk about what I'm gonna be doing after the workout. So typically, after a workout, I just come home, you know, I eat, I don't rush a pre-workout protein shake, or I don't drink a carbohydrate shake like some people do, you know, to maximize recovery. Because if you're training just once a day, then you don't need to rapidly replenish glycogen, and there's not really much scientific evidence as far as, you know, the post-workout shake and spiking insulin. So that doesn't really do anything unless you're training again that day or within a 24-hour period. So what I am going to be doing, since the first workout will be depleting a lot of my glycogen and I don't have a lot of time to replenish that, right after my workout, I'm going to be taking some protein shake, and then also I have this carb drink that I got 2 years ago, like when I first started lifting. I was on a, you know, ultra dirty bulk, eating, you know, 4,500 calories a day. It was outrageous. So I thought for some reason I had to get a carb drink because I was misguided. So I still have a bunch of that left over. So I'm going to take some of that right after my workout, you know, while I'm still at the gym. And then I'm going to come home and I will just feast on, you know, protein and carbs, trying to fuel up for that 7 o'clock. Hopefully, I'll be able to take a nap. Now, I'm not that good at sleeping. It's not a skill that I possess. So falling asleep is going to be doubtful. But if I can, I'm going to come home, feast, and then hopefully just go into a coma for an hour or two, wake up, you know, get some packing done, and then head off to the gym, you know, later around 7 o'clock. But I'm actually kind of looking forward to this. Like I said, I like stuff like this. I like challenging myself because today, you know, my legs are sore to the touch from Wednesday. That was my last leg workout. Like, I can barely walk, they're so sore, but I have to train them again tonight. And pushing my mind, pushing my body, that stuff that I don't, you know, other people would dread, but I like it. That's what I enjoy. This is my passion. So I'm actually looking forward to the immense amount of pain and exhaustion I'll be experiencing, and hopefully I can translate that into video and take you guys along for the ride. So I guess I'll see you guys in the gym for the first workout. Workout number one is completed. That's actually the fastest I've ever done that workout. Finished within an hour and a half. Normally it takes 2.5, maybe even 3 hours, but you know, didn't have my training partner with me. Came at an earlier time, so all the usual suspects that I normally talk to weren't there at that time, so I was able to get it done pretty quickly. I didn't record the full workout just because this video is going to be long enough showing two workouts, so I'm just kind of giving you an idea of what I'm doing. But anyways, going to go home, feast up. I'll kind of show you guys what I'm eating. I actually forgot my protein shake. So we're going to go home, eat up, and I'll talk to you guys in a second. All right, first up is going to be to take that protein shake that I forgot. Now, this is a hydrolyzed whey isolate, which basically means it just absorbs super quickly, digests super quickly, so I can get that in my system. Now, I don't take this all the time. I only take it in, you know, certain situations like this, or if I, you know, I'm gonna take a protein shake in the middle of a workout or something, that way it doesn't upset my stomach. So I still have a ton of this and I got it a long time ago. Hardly ever use it, but we're gonna start off with this. All right, so we're sticking to the theme of easily digestible, fast digested foods. So in terms of carbs, you know, we want to replenish this glycogen as quickly as possible. So eating high glycemic carbs, you know, simple sugar type stuff. That's why I had that carb drink, because, you know, it's digested almost instantly compared to something like a sweet potato or oatmeal, which that's what I would normally choose. But today, you know, there's a little sense of urgency. But after workout, I always eat some ice cream. Going with this Edie's slow churned
pumpkin patch. Pretty low, actually very low in fat
in terms of, you know, ice cream. So it's got 12 grams of sugar. I'm gonna have 3 servings of this, so that's 270 calories and 36 grams of sugar. So that will help, you know, spike some insulin, shuttle some sugar, you know, turn it into glycogen, whatever, replenish. That way we can get this ball rolling. Got about 6 hours until the next workout.
Oh, baby, baby.
All right, so we're finishing off this meal with a chicken sandwich on a bagel. Bagel's gonna get me some carbs in. Chicken just gets more protein, and then I put pickles on it, a lot of pickles actually, because they have a lot of sodium. Now, a lot of people try to make sodium out to be a bad thing. Now, it can cause you to retain some water, which doesn't really matter unless, you know, you're about to get a photo shoot done or step on stage for a bodybuilding competition, or maybe you're trying to impress a girl on a date, like at the beach or something. But as far as performance goes, sodium helps retain water, which helps keep you hydrated. So since I already did a full workout, normally hydration isn't an issue because I have a whole day to do it, so I just drink a lot of water. But I'm gonna need the help of some extra, you know, electrolytes. So that's why I put the pickles, put the sriracha, put the mustard, you know, all high in sodium. Hopefully, you know, help me get everything rehydrated. All right, headed in for the second workout. We have legs. Now, you guys didn't really miss much. After I ate my post-workout meal, I tried to take a nap, although, you know, I still had the pre-workout in my system, so I kind of just laid there for 30 minutes with my eyes shut. But it helped a little bit, just, I don't know, just relaxing, keeping my body still. And then I ate a lot, lots of oatmeal, protein powder, chicken, all that stuff. I think I'm about 400 grams of carbs right now, approaching 3,000 calories. I'm not sure what, I'll put it on the screen, hopefully, what my macros for the day were. I think I'm around like 30 fat, 200 protein, and 400 carbs right now, so definitely a lot. I'll probably hit around 3,500, maybe more calories, depending on how I feel after this workout. But then I was packing up everything for the trip, and there's a lot of like restrictions on things that you can wear. I know I'm not allowed to pack any blue shirts, that's why I'm wearing this blue shirt now, because apparently it attracts like the mosquitoes or something. And then you can't wear red because it, you know, upsets the animals or makes you a target. And then you can't wear camouflage, which, I mean, I don't really have a lot of camouflage stuff anyway, but you can't wear camouflage because, you know, there's a lot of like rebel soldiers and stuff over there, and they'll think that you're part of the rebel army. But then some things that I do want to mention that I packed creatine, just because that's something that you should take every day, and that's something that, you know, your muscles get saturated with. So taking a week off will kind of desaturate you, and you may feel a little bit weaker coming back just from that, and not as much from, you know, the week off. And then of course I packed protein powder. Now, this is gonna be the first trip that I'm not taking my food scale on, just because I'm not gonna have any control over the meals. You know, I'm not gonna be able to weigh anything out. So my fear is, you know, not that I'm gonna be eating too much, but that I'm actually not gonna be able to get enough, because if I'm only eating 3 meals a day, you know, I'd have to get in 1,000 calories per meal. And then of course, you know, I'm not sure what the protein situation is. So I'm taking some protein powder with me. And then as far as training goes, I'm gonna treat this as a deload week, or potentially a week off. I kinda doubt a week off. But anyways, I'm taking a resistance band and my quick release tourniquets for blood flow restriction training. I'm taking those two things with me because, you know, at the actual hotel, there will be a hotel gym. Now, I'm unsure of what all there will be or what all they'll have. But then we'll go on safari for a couple days away from the hotel, where we'll just be staying in a cabin. So with that band, the tourniquets, and then of course body weight exercises. So that would be enough just to get a little bit of activity, so I don't come back extremely, you know, detrained or anything. But I'm not really gonna focus on, you know, in the past I always focus on finding a gym, going, make sure I get my workouts in. I've been training really hard these past couple weeks to kind of overtrain or overreach myself so that I can use this vacation as a deload, or maybe even a week off and just actually enjoy the vacation for once. Because typically vacations are stressful for me because, you know, I have to get up early, I have to go train, I have to find the right foods, and I'll actually be able to enjoy the vacation like a normal person. But enough of me babbling, we're going in for legs. Legs still sore to the touch. I tried foam rolling, but it was so painful, it had me almost in tears. So let's hope this goes well, but I'll see you guys there. Hopefully you guys can see me, but that is it, just finished up. Actually went better than I expected. Squats went very well, although my legs were still sore. And then my patellar tendon on both knees, just I guess from not allowing myself to fully recover, was feeling very inflamed, hurting a lot. And surprisingly, squats actually went pretty well. Worked up to 345 for a set of four. I felt like I had more in me, but I misgrooved the fourth one and almost didn't get it up, so I figured I'd just re-rack it. Then did a conservative AMRAP with 315, ended up getting 8, which once again could have gotten more, but knees were hurting. Didn't want to push it too hard just because I don't want like patellar tendonitis or anything like that. First half of the workout went great, then I just hit the wall or just ran out of gas. Hip thrust, didn't even film. Abs, calves, all that stuff, didn't even film, just like hit the wall of exhaustion. But overall, pretty fun day, to be honest, doing what I love almost all day long, and went better than expected. Hopefully, you know, if you guys have to do this whole training twice a day thing, you can, hopefully you learned a little bit from this video on how you can successfully do that. But if you enjoyed this, please give a thumbs up rating, maybe share it with your friends. But I guess I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.